This video will be a walkthrough of the process for creating a model, designing and creating a model to print in ReplicatorG, so printing on the MakerBot. So I've got Google Sketchup set up here, and the Sketchup to STL plugin with no dialogues, the straight export to STL millimeters. That is from brettbeauregard.com, and that's linked from the MakerBot website. So once that's set up, that's in the tools menu here. So I want to design a pen holder for my Wacom Bamboo pen for my tablet. My old tablet came with one, but this one didn't. I'm using the millimeter product design template here. So we'll start with a circle. And I want this to be about 50 millimeters, so radius of 25 millimeters. And we'll move that over here. Not that it really matters. Okay, anyway, that'll be fine. And then we will push that up about, let's say, 25 millimeters. Well, maybe that's too small. Let's do one slightly larger. Let's say 60 millimeters, so a radius of 30. Right there, and then we'll push that up. Sure, should be good. No, maybe 20. Okay. Now, the pen itself has a diameter of 12 millimeters, so we'll do an offset. The distance across this whole thing is 60 millimeters. Again, the radius of 30. So, if we want to have 12, so that would be 24. Okay, so if we grab our tape measure, that would be, so 12.3 millimeters, sounds about right. Just a little bit larger, hopefully that will be good enough for the pen to fit in. And again, the height of this was 20 millimeters, so we will push the center down, push the center down 18 millimeters, and so that's our pen holder. So that'll sit on my desk, and the pen will fit in the middle. And if we wanted to add some extra design features or anything like that, maybe let's do another offset here, and just to make it look a little interesting, we'll push that down like that. We'll push that down like that, and maybe another one. That's something interesting. Okay, so we've got a model here. Probably want to save it, but we will do a export to STL millimeters. We'll export the whole model, and we'll call this penholder.stl. I had already created one, so. Okay, so there we go. And then in ReplicatorG, we'll open up that penholder. And center it, make sure it's on the platform. And we have the model, what it's going to look like when it's printed. Generate the G codes. Yes, save the model. And I'm using Print-O-Matic here. 15% fill should be fine. Layer height of 0.3, feed rate 30. We can maybe go 35, but that's fine. plastic 1.8 is close enough, and the nozzle diameter of our extruder is 0.4, so that works well. So we'll generate the G code, and this will take a while. We'll take a look at the G codes. We like to have the heated build platform a little warmer, so we're going to turn that up to 130 and save the G code again. So this is all ready to go. We also don't really need this homing section. I'm going to delete that. So we'll print that. Click print to print that on the MakerBot. I've got it set to monitor the build temperatures here. I preheated it just a little bit. Gives us an estimated remaining time for the print of 47 minutes. We'll probably speed that up in this. Plastic here, to there. Plastic is being melted in by the hot extruder, being pushed out and laid down on the platform. This is the automated build platform, so it'll actually spin it off the conveyor belt at the end when it's done. Printing. Okay, we'll let that cool down for a minute and I'll go get the pen and see if it fits. Alright, so here's the pen that we are designing for, the Wacom Bamboo tablet stylus, I guess we should call it. And it's a little tight, a little snug, but it fits in there. And there's the it's a little shiny on the bottom, but there's the pen in the stand. Success.